milestones that I set for myself. All right, now we hit one video, hit 100 views. That was one of the goals that I set for myself, and we just hit 22 subscribers. Now my first goal was set to hit 20 subscribers. Now I hit 22, so I surpassed that. So now it's time to set a new goal for myself. I got a couple small goals that I set for myself, a couple little achievements that I wanted to achieve, and my first two achievements, I've already achieved those too. So now it's time to step it up and put some more goals out there. Eventually I will be making a vision board. Vision boards are really good and really helpful to help you visualize a plan, basically to set a plan in action and visualize that plan and help yourself do it to succeed, so that way you can get that vision out. Basically, that's what I think of a vision board. Anyway, some people may have their own interpretation of a vision board, but my interpretation of a vision board is to help you visualize the goal that you have set for yourself. So you set little small increments and goals. So like I said, my first goal was to get 20 subscribers. All the Facebook friends that I have, all the Instagram followers, all the Snapchat people, things like that. Listen, hey, 20, I didn't even expect to get 10, but I got 20 people who support me. Most of them is family and friends, but I got 20 people supporting me. My video hit 100 views, so that means people are watching the videos, which is a good feeling to know that people are actually watching the videos, man. So I know some people may think in their mind like, oh, that's a small goal, that's a small set, but hey man, listen, I'm blessed to see the day, to see all the views go up, to see people actually watch these videos, man, and to get good feedback from my friends, get good feedback from, you know what I'm saying, my family, and you know what I'm saying, and like, I had a guy comment on one of my videos and tell me, God bless you, like, you know what I'm saying, like, I don't even know this guy, man, but he just commented on my Nipsey video with the marathon clothing, like, that's amazing to me to see, like, that something that I put out there has reached somebody far out from my inner circle, and that's like amazing, man. So I just want to thank all y'all, man, for watching these videos. If you like them, thank you for liking it. If you comment on it, thank you for commenting. You don't know how much it means to me that these videos are getting watched, because that means it's pushing my content up further for more people to see it. So the reason why we stress about subscribing and liking and commenting on these videos is because it basically pushes our videos or our content up further in the algorithm, so people can actually see these videos, man. So thank you, appreciate it, greatly appreciate it, man. I'm really at a loss for words right now, so that's why I'm like really stumbling over my words, man. So thank you so much, man, from the bottom of my heart. I greatly appreciate it. I'm gonna keep going, I'm gonna keep grinding, and I'm gonna do 110% to make this thing work for y'all, man. Okay, so with that being said, all right, so basically what we doing today, I'm about to go to Meijer to pick up a Brita filter, because our Brita filter, it's not working properly. It's giving like a really bad taste to the water. So gotta go get a new Brita filter. Actually, I gotta get a couple of them. So another thing I'm doing is I gotta pick up Steph something to eat. I totally get her some Qdoba today, so I figured we just do that. I also fixed mount here, so I just wonders what a little industrial glue will do to this little bolt right here. So I got that all taken care of, so now I can carry it around and hold it. The last video I was holding it in my hand, so that's why it was like, you know what I'm saying, positioned the way it was positioned. But now that I fixed the mount piece on there, I can hold it properly. I actually got a suction cup mount when I bought the GoPro. So I got the GoPro mount suction to my to the screen on in my car. So that's on there. So that works out a little bit better. So that way I can have my hands free, so I'm not holding something and driving at the same time, and you know, stuff like that happens. You know what I'm saying? You know, bad stuff happens. So, but I was just thinking, man. So I don't know what the heck I'm doing out here, man. It's rush hour right now. It's 4:48 on a Monday. My days are all screwed up because I don't you know what I'm saying? I haven't been to work, so, you know. But I was sitting in the house today and I was thinking, man, I came up with my hoodie concept, my hoodie ideas. So my girl, she knows a guy, he does photography and videography, and now he does his own screen printing for his own clothing. So I linked up with him and gave him my design ideas, and he was like, yeah, bro, for sure, I can print that up for you. And I'm like, oh man, that's dope. So I'm about to get him to print some of these hoodies up. The first couple hoodies that I make are really just gonna be my brand of hoodies, just for me. Basically, it's gonna have my logo, my design that I made on the front, and then on the back, it's gonna have my YouTube channel name and all my my Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter accounts. So it's basically gonna give me exposure, because if I walk around in that hoodie, then people will see like the back of my hoodie and see that it says like, you know, blah blah blah, YouTube, BMAC Tandem, blah blah blah, things like that. I'm gonna actually put what the back of the hoodie will look like. It'll be right here. So that's what the back of the hoodie will look like. It was kind of a joint concept between me and my fiance. So she helped me out a lot with basically, you know, coming up with the concept for everything. So I appreciate her a lot, because like the way I put it together, like it needed like somebody else's opinion on it. And I love the way that it came out. I showed a couple people the concept. You know, you can't show everyone your ideas, you know what I'm saying? But once it does start breaking the ground, then you guys will see it firsthand, what it looks like. It'll probably get posted on my social media accounts. So if you're not following me on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter, go follow me on those. All those social media platforms right now. If you go to my YouTube channel page, up in the right hand corner, it has the links right there. You just click on the icons and it'll take you right to my Instagram or my Facebook. I don't have my Twitter icon up there yet, but my Twitter is BMACTandem or BMAC_Tandem, either one. I have two of them. So man, I was sitting in the house today and I was just thinking, and I'm like, It's really hard to do this type of stuff, man. Like, I'm blessed to have a full month off of work to try and focus on YouTube or focus on doing something. So it's really difficult to do this. It's really difficult to do anything if you think about it. Excuse me. It's really difficult to do anything if you think about it, because whether it's buying and selling shoes, buying and selling cars, buying homes, selling homes, like everything is a risk. Everything is scary. Everything takes time, man, because like, for instance, buying and selling cars, you have to buy the right vehicle and sell it. You have to get the right price to buy the vehicle in order to sell it for a price to make profit. Shoes, You have to do your research on which shoe's coming out. How much is the shoe retail for? How much is the going market for that shoe? If that shoe drops in value before, if the shoe drops in value when it comes out, then you could possibly lose money. So then now what do you got to do? You got to return the shoe, and then you get, you just break even because you return the shoe. Everything is a risk, man. So today I was sitting there, man, I was thinking to myself, like, am I, like, is this really going to work out for me? And then I got done playing 2K. I played 2K for a couple hours today. And I checked on my YouTube channel, and I got a notification that my video reached 100 views. I'm like, whoa. It all set in. Like, man, okay. And then I checked my subscriber count. I'm at 22 subscribers. I'm like, dang. The other day when I checked it, I was only at 18. Like, I was so close to my little short-term goals that I set for myself that it's that quick to get sidetracked from the goal that you set, or from the short-term goals in life that you set. So it's just that simple that you can get sidetracked like that, man. It's crazy, man. This light is out. That's why traffic is all bad right here. Alright, we're gonna go through this love. But yeah, man, you know, it's crazy because you can get sidetracked from your vision of whatever. Like for instance, like, honestly, I don't wanna work for somebody my whole entire life. Like, I've always had aspirations of owning my own business. I just never knew how to own my own business or to get to that stage of knowing what to do to even start the business up. And now that I've been doing my own research on whether YouTube or whatever, like, whatever the case may be, like, it's like, you really just have to go for it and just do it. You know what I'm saying? So one of my things that I want to do in life is I want to start my own detailing business, car detailing. Now, you may think like, oh, well, there's a bunch of car washes and things like that. Why would people want to do that? Well, just think about it this way. If I have a truck, a van, a big van, if I have a van, I have my own compressors, my own vacuums, my own cleaning products, my own everything. I got my own everything. Everything I got. I got my own power washer. Everything like that. So I don't need nothing from your household. No water, no electricity, no nothing. Everything's built right into my van. I come to your house and I wash your car. You don't even have to leave the house. Or you can be at work. I could come while you at work, wash your car, boom, 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 you know, spray it down, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And then you pay me, I leave, your car is washed, it's out there, it's dry, it's looking shiny, blah, blah, blah. And then, like, especially, like, here in Michigan, like, you wouldn't believe how many people get car washes in the wintertime just to get the salt off their car. So, if I'm open 24 hours a day, not 24 hours a day, sorry. If I'm open 7 days a week, if I'm available 7 days a week to come to your house or come wherever you need me to wash your car, I mean, I think it would be a successful business because, I mean, granted, yeah, there's like a couple places out here that are like that, but they charge you so much to do it, you just basically end up hiring somebody off like Craigslist or something that says they detail cars, and then they come in their car with like a bucket, and then they pour water and they wash your car, things like that. Like, it's just no real like subside to it. So, I mean, and that's just my opinion. That's just what I want to do. But, you know, I've been in the car wash industry when I was a kid. My first job I ever had was working at a car wash, man. And working at a hand car wash where we hand wash the cars with microfiber rags and hand dry them with microfiber rags. No scrubbing of brushes, nothing like that. Like, the car wash used to bang. I mean, 40, 50 cars first thing in the morning, like in Detroit, like in the hood, like, you know, all the hood people bring their cars, their Rams. They don't want to, you know, get them scratched up going through the automated car washes. Bring them to us. We wipe them down. We clean them all up. Like, that junk is crazy, man. How people really like want that. Like, and then now you got all these cars that have like the ceramic coating and the PPF films and things like that on them, where you don't even have to wash them. All you gotta do is just spray them down and they look brand new. But not everybody can afford. Not everybody can afford an $8,000 PPF film on their car. You know what I'm saying? Not everybody can afford that. But everybody can afford a $7 or $8 car wash. Or once I get big enough, I can start doing monthly payment plans where you pay me a monthly fee of, let's say, $40 a month. I come clean your car anytime you want. Anytime you want, any day of the week you want, as many times as you want. It's unlimited car washes for $40 a month. Like, would you not jump on that? Somebody, you ain't got to go nowhere. You can come straight home. Like, hey, man, you know, I'll be home in a little bit. I need you to come wash my car tonight. Okay, cool. I'm sitting outside your house. Wash your car up before you get ready to go out on night on the town or something like that. Like, that would be dope as heck, man. Like, so that's one of my things. You know, I know you're not supposed to put your stuff out there because, you know, people may steal your ideas, but it's like, whatever, man. You know, it's like, you still can do it and you still can strive. All you gotta do is believe in yourself and believe in your visions and believe in your dreams, and they'll come true. So, but I'm pulling up to Meijer. I'm gonna vlog a little bit while I'm in Meijer because I gotta get out in public and start vlogging, man, so I can feel more comfortable in front of the camera, more comfortable in front with myself vlogging out in public. So, even if I'm not talking about much or it's just me walking around, I got to do it because I got to get used to it, man. So I'll see y'all in a minute. Peace. Okay. I'll see y'all in a minute. Peace, man. I was
also looking at some like Velcro stuff because I was thinking about instead of suction cupping that to the to my screen, because I don't know if it's going to mess it up or not, but I was going to suction cup not suction cup, but adhesive the Velcro strip to the dashboard and possibly find a way to put it on the bottom of the camera so it can just Velcro stick right to the camera. But I don't really see anything in here like that, so especially that'll work for it, because I don't want to mess up nothing. And nah, I'm not seeing nothing, but got what I came in for.
Got the Brita filters, and then I got that black ice little tree. So I think I might go back over there and see if they got something else.
I really don't like black ice now that I'm thinking about it. So, and it was only on sale by like 20 or 30 cents. So I'm about to go back over there, check that out, and then go to Qdoba and then head home, man. So that's it for this one. The next video will be a sit-down video. This one's going up probably tonight, which is Monday. If not, it'll go up tomorrow, which is Tuesday. And then the next video will go up on Wednesday. So, if I don't pick up the camera before I get home, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace. Having said it already, please like this video, comment on this video, and subscribe to the channel, baby. That's all I want. Appreciate it. I'm busy, Mari. Got